only 2 days left to Christmas, and there is obviously cheer in the air, but it's also true that we have got less than 2 weeks to the new year. So what have you got planned for 2022? Make sure to enjoy, but also don't lose track. Welcome to The Business Show. Now here is a look at what's trending in the business world. Uganda, Congo speakers vote for regional economic cooperation. Tanzania reaps big from Uganda's trade fights with Kenya and Rwanda. Rising cost of cooking gas interferes with Nigeria's climate plan. And Sri Lanka plans to pay off Iran oil debt with tea.
The lifeline tariff of 15 units still can run a typical domestic household.
There was more business in the fertilized eggs than in selling the birds themselves.
The Electricity Regulatory Authority has introduced a cooking tariff plan that's meant to see a reduction in billing for industries and home cooking. In the new tariff structure plan, we have to see homeowners using electricity for cooking paying 412 shillings, that is at the start of 2022 January. These users will have to have used between 81 to 150 units of power. On Views from the Top, Vianney Mutyaba, who is the manager power pricing at ERA, speaks to us in detail about this.
My name is Vianney Mutyaba. I work as a pricing manager at the Electricity Regulatory Authority, an institution that is established under the Electricity Act, with one of its functions to set electricity tariffs for all companies operating in the electricity supply industry in Uganda. As part of the tariff review for the tariff of 2022, the ERA has made changes to the tariff structure that is to be charged by Umeme Limited. One of the changes is in respect to the lifeline tariff, or also called the social tariff. The social tariff is the first 15 units in every month that is consumed by all domestic consumers, charged at 250. The authority has made changes to the qualification criteria of the lifeline tariff because the essence of the lifeline tariff is to support low income earners, people that don't earn a lot of money but also would want to consume electricity or be connected to the grid. So because in the previous tariff structure that we had, all domestic consumers were benefiting from the lifeline tariff. The first 15 units were being charged at 250. So the authority has made changes to ensure that only deserving customers benefit from the lifeline tariff. And that change is because the lifeline is supposed to support low-income earners, we have established that the level of consumption of electricity is a good representation of income levels for our customers on the electricity grid. So because you cannot be rich and poor at the same time, based on our review of all the customers that are connected to the grid, we have established that if we set the threshold at the cutoff at 100 units for all customers that consume more than 100 units per month, we will no longer need the requirement of a lifeline tariff, because based on their consumption they can be classified as either medium or high income level customers to which the lifeline tariff is not meant to benefit. In other words, they are not deserving customers. So the way it's going to work starting January 2022 is that for every customer that has six months average of consumption that exceeds 100 units per month will not qualify for the lifeline. And if your consumption for the last 6 months is below 100 units, then you qualify for the lifeline. The lifeline in itself is not changing. It is still 150. It's still 250 shillings for the first 15 units, but the qualification for the lifeline has been set at 100 units. So when your average consumption over the last 6 months exceeds 100 units per month, then you don't qualify for the lifeline, and if it's below 100, then you qualify. So based on our review that we've done for the customers that are connected to the grid and their previous consumption, we noted that 90% of the customers that are connected to the grid will still qualify for the lifeline tariff, as the case has been previously. So still speaking to affordability concerns that we are trying to address. So 90% of the customers will still qualify for the lifeline tariff, even with this initiative. Based on our review of the consumption of the respective customers that are connected to the national grid, we note that even with the change, the customers that will lose, or the undeserving customers in terms of the lifeline, will have just a marginal increase in their bill of not more than 8,000 shillings per month. While the customers that really need the lifeline in terms of supporting their connectivity to the grid still benefit, because the lifeline tariff of 15 units still can run a typical domestic household for lighting, watching TV, and charging the phone and basic electricity usage in a typical household. So there's no significant increase in the bill of the non-deserving customers. It's only 8,000 shillings at maximum. So the other initiative that we've run is introduction of a declining block tariff, or what we would call a cooking tariff for domestic consumers. So the way the declining block tariff works is that the tariff reduces as you increase consumption. So the reason we have introduced a declining block or the cooking tariff for domestic consumers is, one, to speak to affordability of the tariff and give an incentive for our customers to cook using electricity, but also, more importantly, making sure that the financial sustainability of the electricity supply industry is maintained. Of course, there are issues that we've also discussed or considered in respect to the environment. We are trying to provide an incentive for people or domestic consumers to cook using electricity, as opposed to using charcoal. And we all know the impact of using charcoal, deforestation and the impact that has on the climate and the trickle-down effect. Of course, also, as electricity supply industry, we are looking at giving incentives to increase consumption of electricity, which directly also feeds into tariff reduction, because we have a number of generation plants that both have been funded by government and the private sector. So we have generation capacity, so we want to provide an incentive for people to increase consumption, targeting the domestic consumer. So the more energy that is consumed, then automatically it will result into a reduction in the tariff, because the costs are already fixed. So the more you consume, the more you spread the costs over many units, which results into a reduction in the tariff. So based on the numbers that we've done, for the first 80 units that are going to be consumed by a domestic household connected to the Umeme network, the first 80 units will be billed at the normal rate. So that normal rate will depend whether you're a deserving customer of a lifeline or you're not, but that will be on the normal rate. Then the units between 80 and 150 per month, that is the band that we are setting for cooking for 70 units, ranging from the 81 unit to 150th unit. So those will be at a lower tariff of 412 shillings per kilowatt hour. Then after the 150th unit, so from unit 151 going until the end of the consumption for that particular month, then those again will be billed at the normal tariff rate. So If I can explain further why we decided on the 80 units, how we decided on the 100 and on the 150 cutoff units per month, and how we did of the 412 shillings per kilowatt hour. So in determining the 80 units, and the cutoff after which you qualify for the cooking tariff, we reviewed typical households that are consuming electricity across the network, what they are using electricity for, and we found out that if you look at a typical household, if you look at issues like lighting, boiling water, the fridge, TV, charging the phone, if the household has really maxed out on all those consumption areas of consumption, then a typical household would be consuming around 80 units per month on basic electricity usage other than cooking. So based on our review, we note that the only thing that is going to push electricity, domestic electricity consumers into increased consumption is by cooking using electricity. So at 80th, on the 80th unit, you've really consumed energy for all other uses other than cooking. So we think after the 80th unit, we should be able to give you a tariff that provides you that incentive to cook using electricity, but also increase your consumption over the 80 units that you've already consumed under normal rate. So we also did a review and noted that if you look at typical households, how often they cook, how long they take to cook, and the time at which they cook, you find that many of the households would use 70 units a month to cook using electricity. So we were able to look at a typical meal, you know, we looked at the gadgets on the market in terms of their wattage, in terms of their consumption when they are being used. So that's how we determine the 70 units. So it's scientifically determined. And then 80 plus 70, we come to the 150. Then we determine that after the 151st unit of consumption, then you are using electricity for other uses, not typically for cooking. So probably we have households that are also doing commercial activities inside their homes, inside their domestic homes. Yes, they have a domestic meter and they are given a domestic bill, but probably they are doing a bakery in their home or they are doing laundry. So that is not the target that we have for this particular initiative. So we think that if you move above 150, then you could be using power for other things, commercial activities. So that is why, and we don't want to give an incentive for commercial consumers to shift businesses into homes by giving them a tariff that is lower than the commercial tariff, which is the cooking tariff. So that is why after the 150th unit, then we go back to the normal rate to provide that safeguard to avoid abuse for the initiative. Now the 412 shillings per kilowatt hour that our board has approved has also been scientifically determined. We went and compared the cost of charcoal on the market. How much does a bag of charcoal cost? If you buy a bag of charcoal, how many meals does it cook? How long does it take to cook? How long do you use the bag of charcoal before it's finished? So the tariff that we've determined at 412 shillings per kilowatt hour is actually is more competitive. It's cheaper for you to use electricity now based on the analysis we've done than use charcoal, which is the bag ranges between 60 and 80,000. So we've done that calculation and we've made sure that it is more economical for a domestic consumer now to shift to using electricity than charcoal, which is different from the case that we've been running previously.
Last year, on the onset of COVID-19, not everyone actually saw a loss. Some people actually saw a new beginning. We shall be seeing that after the break. Stay tuned.